Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's talk about dividing text into columns in Pages. So Pages is actually the number one selling Mac app. You always see it there at the top of the top selling list in the Mac App Store, right after Mountain Lion itself. So I decided to write an entire book on Pages. It's called My Pages and it just came out. You can get it in bookstores and online places like Amazon. Here's a link to where you can go directly and buy it right now. Let's take a look at an excerpt from it about how to divide text up in columns from Chapter 5. So here's an excerpt from Chapter 5 and you could see that everything is broken into specific tasks like using text columns, and then there's step by steps. Steps are spelled out here with exactly what to do, and then you see figures with callouts to show you what the results are, and you can see exactly where to click. It's very similar to my iPad books and it's part of that same series. So for using text columns, we can see the steps are to start with a document that has some text in it and click on the columns button in the toolbar and go to the two columns option. And then you'll see the results. Let's switch over to Pages and do exactly that. Here I've got a document with some text in it. I'm going to select the columns button here and switch to two columns. And then you can see now I've got two columns in my document. Now that's the simplest way to do it, but the steps here continue telling you that you can bring up the inspector window, go to the layout inspector and into layout, and you can set the number of columns there as well. And you can also go further and set the column width. So let's take a look at that. If I click on here to bring up the inspector, I can now go to, see I'm already at the layout section, layout, and I can see the columns here. I can add more columns, like three columns, I'll go back to two, and I can indeed set the column size and even the gutter between these two columns here in the inspector. And there's even more. The steps continue to talk about if you want different numbers of columns for different sections of the Pages document. Now it's not exactly sections. You're going to do what's called a layout break here, which is outlined in step 12. And the layout break will allow you to have some parts of your document with two columns and some with one. So for instance, we can go back to here and I can set a layout break here to be at the end of the section. So let's change everything back to one column and then put a layout break right here. So I'm going to go insert and then layout break. Now I'm going to change this section here to have two columns, and you can see now the first section here is still one column and the second section has two. I could have put in that break right after this heading here, so I can go down and insert another layout break. Then I can go back to this one here and set that to a one column. And now it's even neater. There's also lots of little tips in the sidebars here. For instance, one that applies to the columns here is column breaks. You can use insert column break to force text to jump to the beginning of the next column. So for instance, in here, if I wanted this column to go to the top right after this, I can put the cursor there, do insert, and do column breaking. You can see it jumps to the top of the column there. That can come in very handy if you have specific needs for your layout. So that's just one little section, and there's well over 100 different sections that breaks up just about everything you can do in Pages for Mac, so you can learn all the ins and outs of it. And if you use Pages to write reports for school or reports for work or just things at home, you can learn all about Pages, not just the word processing stuff, but a lot of the page layout stuff. A lot of people don't know how powerful Pages is as a good page layout document to create flyers, newsletters, things like that. So check it out. I hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.